Hi everybody, Bud Brown here. Can you believe that it has been 4 years since I made my first video right here in this spot? I can't believe it. Hey, I'm telling you, if you want to do anything in this life, you need to get started because time goes by like that. I mean, you turn around twice and 10 years have gone by. Well, anyway, what I wanted to share in this video was an encouragement to learn languages, but learn anything that you want and get started right now. But I wanted to share a little story with you. In 1968, I joined the Navy, and I told myself, I'm joining the Navy because somebody told me they had a language school there, and I was very interested in languages. So, I joined with the hopes of being able to use languages in some way. Well, I took a aptitude test for languages in boot camp, which is, you know, to show you, aptitude test will tell you what abilities you have. You know, we're weak in some things and strong in other things. And so, the Navy would like to spend time on what your strength is. So, lo and behold, they said that I had an ability to learn languages, and so I was going to be sent to a language school. Oh boy, I was so happy. So, they asked me, what languages would you like to study? Your first choice, second choice, and third choice. And they gave me a list of 30 languages, and I would get to choose. So, I thought to myself, wow. I think I would like to learn French because it's a international language like English, and that would be my first choice. My second choice I think would be German because also there's a lot of German speakers not only in Europe but South America also. And my third choice, even though I did speak Spanish at the time, would be Spanish because it's also used in South America, Central America, as well as Europe. So that was my first three choices. 2 weeks later, I got my orders and they said, congratulations, you're going to be studying Vietnamese. And I thought, what? Vietnamese? Oh! You know, at that time I'm thinking, there's only one little bitty country that speaks Vietnamese, and that's Vietnam. And right now, the Americans are there, and it's not a good situation. 1968, huh? So, grudgingly, I went, and it was a language school, a military language school, and so I spent 1 year studying Vietnamese. Well, it was fun, and it was interesting. But I wasn't that happy at the time. This was in 68. Well, it ends up that I did go to Vietnam and the Philippines and spent time in that area, and I had a good time. And then when I got out in 1972, I went back to work in construction, which is what I did when I was a young man. And kind of put this language, Vietnamese, in my back pocket. Didn't really use it because in my small town here in Central California, there was no Vietnamese speakers. So I almost forgot about it. Then lo and behold, in 1975, 3 years later, there was a large influx of Vietnamese coming to the United States. All these Vietnamese, most of them did not speak English. And so guess what? There was a tremendous need for someone to teach English to the Vietnamese. And there was lots of opportunities for English teachers to teach English to the Vietnamese. And guess what? When they asked if there's any possible American that can speak Vietnamese, I thought, hey, I speak Vietnamese. They couldn't believe it. I was a little bit rusty, but I started brushing up, and that was my very first teaching job, was teaching English to the Vietnamese refugees at that time. Well, I'm telling you this story because you never know what the future holds. I studied Vietnamese for 1 year. I wasn't that excited about it, but I did put in an effort and I tried to learn as best I could. When I got to Vietnam, I was so happy to be able to talk with the people. I learned to love the Vietnamese culture, the people, the food, and even that part of the world. And it turns out that my wife is from the Philippines, which I wouldn't have met her if I hadn't gone to Vietnam, because I was going back and forth from the Philippines to Vietnam. So let me tell you this. If you decide to learn a language by happenstance or because of your own choice, do the best you can to learn it. It may seem hard, you may be frustrated, but in the long run, you're going to be so happy that you did, and it'll open a lot of doors for you that never would have been opened if you hadn't studied and learned that language. So that's all I wanted to share with you this time. So, find the language that you would like, or if you're in high school or college and you have to take a certain language to graduate, take advantage of it. Do the best you can. Even if you don't think that you're going to use it in the future, you never can tell. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Until next time, this is Bud Brown saying bye-bye.